Denny's Stadium in Tuscaloosa, Alabama, the site today as the Crimson Tide puts a 16-game home win streak on the line, welcoming Middle Tennessee State. Kenyon Drake back from injury. Finds the sideline, sheds a man, and Drake gives Bama great field position. Derrick Henry is in the backfield. First play is play action. Looking for the tight end. Covered there. Coker trying to redirect traffic, and in trouble, he dumps it all game. So second and 10. Coker lets it go out to Stewart. Can't break through this.
In the back end, Kevin Byard.
Incomplete on third and 6. Couple of wobblers last week, trying to get off to a good start. Catch taken at the 18. And Ed Batiste takes it out to the redshirted him his first year. He's a lefty, and he gets it out to the flat, complete to Christian Collis. And Collis lost the football. Was he down or not? They say Alabama has recovered.
It would have been Geno Smith. Out in the open field, they're out there fighting and scratching, and Smith is the guy that recovers the fumble. I think it's Humphrey, the redshirt freshman, with a heads-up play to rake it out of there.
Marlon Humphrey, second-year freshman from Hoover, has put Alabama. Henry, the feature back. He is a power running back. Instead, they toss it on the sweep to Kenyon Drake. Drake can't find the edge. He stood up there and finally twisted and turned. And he goes down after a season. Not here with Coker under center and Henry deep. Here's a handoff to number 2. Hit in the backfield. Nothing doing there. Immediately, this is a kid, when he graduated high school in Antioch, Tennessee, went to work at the Nissan plant. Now he's playing against Alabama at Bryant-Denny Stadium. Richard Mullaney trips to the top of the formation. Out that way. This is Robert Foster. He's got room. And he wins the foot race for a 19-yard touchdown.
And a bad angle by Singletary at the top. Watch here, the corner coming in. He goes inside the block. You can't give up outside leverage. It's actually Jeremy Cottrell.
Four play, 32-yard scoring drive set up by the strip and recovery. And the extra point is good. Alabama with 3-and-out. Short kick taken on a hop by Jeremiah Bryson. Bryson gets crunched last year. Just no huddle, spread attack for Middle Tennessee. And a handoff on first down to Jordan Parker. No longer will they stick with just one unit on the field and let the offense dictate to them personnel groupings. Nice completion and a fine move by Richie James.
From the sideline, you can get players on and off the field.
And they certainly have plenty of depth. Here's Parker again. And Parker,
this football game.
Second and 9 for the Blue Raiders. Stock still over the middle, complete. Here's a first down to Richie James.
And that's against smaller slot receivers.
So Middle Tennessee driving here back to the ground, and Parker
gives him, he's giving that offense, it gives him some headaches.
On second and 7, they're running it again, and they've got a first down for Parker.
Better than Wisconsin's.
To throw again, trying to get it outside, incomplete, aiming
good job
for
about 10 days before the season started.
Completion.
Well, you see how he's executing here early.
Low snap. He scoops it up and has to scramble. Stockstill fires on the run. Incomplete. Second possession of the game. Snap and hold were good. The kick's losing air, and it's going to fall short and wide.
It's right on that flat flag drag combination.
Swing it to the outside. This is Stewart. And he gets dragged down from behind after gain.
Put him on film, sat down with Kenyon, and told him, hey, let the game come to you. Don't force anything. It's something that Kenyon
is against Northern Illinois, return for the Tangerine Bowl. Coker looking downfield. Checks to his tight end. This is O.J. Howard.
And he's going to be showing the numbers to the quarterback.
Play action. Coker fires it to his tight end again. Off of his. Coker lets it go to the outside. Complete.
Well,
Calvin Ridley.
Excellent job.
Coker with the check. Here's Drake. And he gets taken down behind the line of scrimmage. No. Coker facing a blitz. Pulls it back. Lets it go and finds the bench. Middle Tennessee State. Now running back for Middle Tennessee State. his first tote. And he tries to go over the right side, picks up 2.5. 5 wide, empty backfield, no huddle for Middle Tennessee. Another bobbled snap. Stockstill able to regather. Who's open? Anybody? Nobody. Instill, redshirt freshman from Murfreesboro, looking to throw to the outside and complete.
What nice throwing.
Next to his quarterback, Stockstill. On a little counter, he's got it over the right side. He's got room, and he bounced off a couple of tied defenders to pick up the first down and fight for more.
Beautiful formation. 5 players in the backfield on the offense. 5-yard penalty from the previous spot. Replay first down.
Mark Curls are a white hat. Quarterback, the real value lies at right tackle. Designed quarterback run, Stockstill with the fake.
It's just the opposite for Brent Stockstill.
This is Tucker. He's got room and takes a lick as he takes it to the 40.
Middle Tennessee offensive line did a nice job.
And now they're going with some tempo on third down. Did they get it?
Close.
Tucker with the carry. Ragland, the first man down. Tucker's got it. And he may have snuck through. Brother now on the field for Middle Tennessee State. The Bama transfer at one fullback, and he's able to create a little bit of a seam.
They throw in 4 offensive line starters returning. A lot of experience.
Here's Tucker again, and he gets waylaid.
Uncovered there for a long time.
Stock still looking that way on the slant. It's complete. First down for Middle Tennessee. Play the drive for Middle Tennessee State. Swinging it out to Richie James. Cuts back in, but it takes 4.
By Middle Tennessee State.
Hand off to Bryson. Cuts back. Gets spun around and dropped. Tucker takes the snap. Design misdirection, lost the football. Alabama's got it for the 2 bad snaps today.
Yep, you see here, moving out of the way, they're gonna get cute, snap it directly. He acts as though he doesn't know what's going on, trying to fool the defense, but he forgets to secure the snap. And actually, credit Josh Chester, put it right in his.
Jaron Reed had the recovery, and now we've got a flag before Alabama gets the playoff.
Gonna be a false start. They were coming with a corner blitz.
False start, number 13, offense. Half the distance to the goal. Correction.
Coker hands to Henry. Henry gets backed up. Tremendous play. Coker flushed. Gets tripped up. Just the longest run of the first quarter for Alabama. Looking deep. Flag on the play. Incomplete. Just a hair behind his intended receiver, Stewart.
Maybe a hold here, but there was a collision. A blitzing
line. Number 74 offense. Penalties decline. Fourth down.
A blitzing end zone.
High but short. And it's taken on the logo. Stockstill fakes, takes off straight up the gut, and he's scrambling. Out to Richie James, got a key block there, dances for the first down. And
the football, it's turnovers that have been the difference.
And they've missed a field goal. Here's Jordan Parker to the outside. Geno Matias. Stockstill hands it off to Parker. Nearly doubled up Alabama in terms of total yards here through one quarter of play, but 2 turnovers.
Just 4 plays.
Stockstill to throw on 3rd and 5. Over the middle, complete. And a first down for Terry Pettis, a former wide receiver. Last week against Wisconsin. Here's Shane Tucker. He gets slammed to the ground for a loss. Defensive back on for Alabama. They'll be there 90% of the time today. Down the sideline. Too much.
Doing it a little bit.
Number 84. Downfield was covered up. Penalties declined. Third down.
Doesn't cost him a ton, but another formation.
Covered slot again.
4-man rush over the middle. Caught. Down to the line. After that gain of 21. Tucker bowled over behind the line of scrimmage. Stockstill rolls left. Stops. And backing up, throws it incomplete. Looking at Tucker. Now back to the right side and batted incomplete. Last year's numbers for Clark, and he punches this one through.
4 defenses, that's what he faced last week. Middle Tennessee poses a different problem with a 4-3 front.
A couple of yards deep into the end zone and out past the 20. For the 24 is Kenyon Drake. Play action to Henry. Coker looking. Complete. There's the tight end, O.J. Howard, and he's free. Inside the 30. Still not going to Henry. Trying to go deep here. Overthrown and incomplete. Late adjustment from Lane Kiffin. Here's Henry in a big hole. First down for Allen. Out of the pistol now for the second time today. Henry breaks through a shoestring tackle.
Still get downhill type runs with Henry.
Henry again.
We had a credit have him go lateral.
Third and short, Derrick Henry. Cut down at the line of scrimmage.
A nose tackle and work into the second level of the defense.
Coker looking that way. Goes to the end zone into coverage. And it is broken up by Ardarius. Eighth play of the drive for Alabama. On second and 10, Coker out to Stewart. He gets flipped at the line of scrimmage. Pressure coming. Coker incomplete.
Flag on defense. The penalty is a first down at the spot of the foul.
So a fresh set of downs. First and goal, Derrick Henry dancing. Then it gets submarines.
Last week with six tackles. He's got solid range.
Henry is in for the extra point. He's got to hold it after the ball blew off the tee a moment ago. And that one drilled through the back of the end zone. Let's check in with Laura for 99 yards through the air so far today. And play action trying to set up the screen. They do so. And a nice gain to Richie James. Mature week 5, 6, or 7. We want to make sure we got the best team on the field.
Injuries or guys just start to get tired.
Fitzpatrick just got here, arrived in June, trying to go to the flat. Catch made by Jordan Parker. Flicked over the middle, coverage by Rattler.
You want the matchup.
Third and 8. A bullet to the outside. They get it off. And hand it off. Jordan Parker. Batted away at the line of scrimmage. Going to add to their total here in the second. Stock still. Long throw, deep. Hung it up, and it's picked off by Cyrus Jones. First team All-SEC selection. The former wide receiver made the switch, but still has the great hands. Jones with Bama's third takeaway, and Alabama back on offense. And a little toss sweep to Kenyon Drake. That'll be a pass in the book for Coker, and Drake has the sideline. Here he goes, needing a block. He's got a convoy with him. Kenyon Drake dragged down from behind at the 1. 68-yard.
As he was trying to set up the block of Stewart, number 13, out in front right here. And Stewart does a nice job of holding off a defender for quite some time, and it allowed Kevin Byard to catch Kenyon Drake.
And now Henry again. Derrick Henry with his second score. 24 seconds. Alabama, after the long run by Drake, got to the ball in a hurry.
You're listening.
Here's Bryson from just outside the end zone. Nice return out to the 30. Out to the edge, and Christian Collins. You see that, second and 7. Stockstill rolling to his strong side. Surveys, throws across his body and incomplete.
Oh, you got to catch.
They bring two extra men. Pass is complete in traffic. Jones will field it after a couple of hops. And takes it out to the 38.
Was down. Personal foul. Late hit. Number 98, kicking team. 15-yard penalty from the end of the run. First down.
Four. On play action. Looking way deep. And he dials long distance. Overthrew it. It is ruled incomplete.
For Batiste.
Stock still looks back to his right. We've got multiple flags.
They drop out and show a man look, press man.
Before the snap, ball start, number 54 offense. Half the distance to the goal, still first down.
To the outside, great hands by Rod. Handoff. Tucker, flag on the play.
Illegal formation, five in the backfield on the offense.
Here it comes.
And they run right into the pressure. Denzel. They come after it. Alabama blocks it out of the back of the end zone. Ronnie Harrison.
Get out of there. You've got to rush this thing. He's taking way too long. And it allows Ronnie Harrison an opportunity to get a hand on it. Nice job of taking it right off the punter's foot and not going into him. Well, that's excellent work right there.
Mullaney from the 35. Here he goes to midfield. To the slant and caught. Robert
Foster. He was advertised coming out of high school.
Out of the pistol, this is Drake. Bounces for a first down. Coker facing a blitz over the middle, incomplete, trying to find Drake.
That's one you got.
On second and 10, another blitz coming off the hands of Ardarius Stewart from Middle Tennessee State. On third down, Coker facing another blitz. Complete to his tight end, O.J. Howard with China. Neither one had more than one in the top 10. On the slant, that's complete for a first down to Robert.
At that point in time of the game.
So Coker rolls down and delivers complete and a crunching hit.
Now you have the play that you want called correctly.
On the defense, 12 players on the field. That's 5-yard penalty from the previous spot. Replay first down.
It's been amazing for Middle Tennessee, Rick.
Coker on first and 5. Wow. Cottrell nearly stole that one.
Yeah, I think we're going to have a holding penalty against Dominique Jackson working against our Marine,
holding
Stephen Rose.
Number 76 offense. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. Replay first down.
Air traffic controller in the Marines. And he almost got to Coker there. Coker on the run. Flicks it to the sideline. Long throw, a little bit high, but hauled in by Robert Foster. Makes a move and takes it inside the 15. Wow. Now Alabama going Temple, caught Middle Tennessee in a personnel switch. Coker over the middle, caught inside the 10. It's Drake. Outside the upright. He's missed his last lead over Middle Tennessee State in the home opener. Right as the half started, Laura Rutledge had a chance to catch
up. The ball consistently. You know, things of that sort. What he's talking about.
Here's Jeremiah Bryson deep in the end zone, and he will take a knee. 48 snaps in the first half. They ran 95 last week. Swing out to Batiste. And he lost the football. They put it on the ground again. Was he down?
And he did just that. He increased his accuracy.
Nothing doing on the handoff. They'll run more pistol with him. They do it here, and he swings it out to Stewart. Hit behind the line of scrimmage, and they're going back here on third and 13. They bring four off the hand against Wisconsin, but just missed him. And this one will head short. Parker joins him in the backfield. Quick hitter to the outside, Richie James. Down the sideline.
Yeah, man. Tennessee State, you've got to start rewarding your
holding
defense.
Number 80, offense. Oh, 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Replay first down.
A lot of bodies down there. Long.
Facing first and long. Down the sideline. Push off and a grab by Batiste, and this one might be coming.
Pass interference, number 81, offense. Half the distance to the goal from the previous spot. Replay first down.
Let's take a look here. It's the one-on-one matchup. Stock still locates it. And right here, it goes back and just, I don't know that I see much there, to be quite honest. Maybe that's just
first and 30. Stock still pulled it back. Nice nifty move to get to the inside.
Sure, young man. Has all his business in order.
That was Reggie's eighth.
Basically, when you were about 1 year old.
Third and 21. Richie Jr. Jones from the 39. Taken down.
He does turn on the film, and that's what you see right away.
Here's Kenyon Drake, and he's got a first down. Ryan Kelly. Here's a toss to Drake. Looking for room. And he picks
award
up.
Award winners putting a list together of potential award winners.
Kelly got to the second level, and then Bateman scrambles for a first down.
Maybe fired here, 20 coming in late. That's could be helmet to helmet. That is tough. This is when there's gray area in this rule for me.
After the runner was down, personal foul, late hit, number 20 defense with targeting. 15-yard penalty, correction, half the distance to the goal. The play is under review.
An ejection here would cost by. Trying to create some room for Kenyon Drake. And he's to the five. Dances his way to the goal line. Flipped right at the line, and he's in. Touchdown, Alabama.
In real speed, it looked as though he may have been just shy right there. I'm not sure when he touches. Cottrell is a guy that comes in and meets
him. I'm not going to take a look. Four play, 55-yard scoring drive. What a pleasant day at Bryan Denny Stadium. With a 30-3 lead, this is Jeremiah Bryson from the goal line. And he is brought down shy of the Tom Bateman. And he also had the 68-yard gain on the same play from Coker. Pass complete to the edge. Braces each and every day on both right and left shoulders. And he comes up and makes a punishing hit.
Like that.
Here's Shane Tucker. Wrapped up after a gain of one by Jaron Reed, the senior.
On the other hand, is not what he likes to do in terms of trying to defend Middle Tennessee. The terminology in their offensive playbook.
A lot of hang time on this one. Jones asks for a fair catch and takes it just outside of the third. Here's Cooper Bateman out of the shotgun, finding Kenyon Drake. Drake spun around three different Blue Raiders. Here's Drake, got a man running in front of him. Nice cutback behind Ryan Kelly. Oh, nearly intercepted. Cooper Bateman in Denver to kick it away. Beauty. Fair catch at the 22.
That's what it's been for Middle Tennessee.
A quartet of them over the middle, open, complete to Richie James. He's had a nice. Here's Jeremiah Bryson, pick up a five.
They can't substitute. They can't get guys in and get in that rotation.
12 players on the field on the defense. The five-yard penalty results in a first down.
Alabama tries to sneak some players in.
Here's Tucker. It's really
conversation with him about that very thing.
Stock still throws up his back foot. Three, third and six. Oh, dangerous pass. Nice punt. Down by Middle Tennessee inside the five.
The University of Alabama, the excitement around basketball right now has never been closer to the action, across from the visitors' bench, and they're excited about it. Yesterday, I went and talked to our
down in Texas, and nobody's going to outwork Avery Johnson, that's for sure.
Well, he's already getting it done. He's one of four new head
players will feel it. Recruits will feel it. Parents of recruits will feel it.
Henry gets the first down. Back to action. Here's Henry again. Got tripped up.
No way.
On second and seven, Henry this time moving fast.
That's that cool.
Here's Henry. Straight at the hash. Into Middle Tennessee territory. On play action, Bateman fires incomplete. Second and 10. Complete to the edge to Calvin Ridley. Back from his knee injury.
Linebacker T.T. Barber inside.
Here's Henry again. And he will take it in again. 28-yard touchdown run for Derek. Extra point is good. 37. They got a bunch of running backs in that game. Samaje Perine's been held to just 16 yards by the Tennessee D. Bryson got leveled at the 15-yard. Last year starter, Austin Grammer. Stock still trying to go for the pump and go into coverage. Leaping attempt off the hands.
Still won the job and allows them to do just that.
Well, they went 1-3 in November.
Offensively and defensively.
Third and six. Looking deep. Checks down to a crossing route. And Batiste is brought down just short. Wow. It was a fantastic punt from Trevor Owens.
Make some better decisions.
Bateman goes over the middle. Incomplete. Trying to find the freshman. One of seven Alabama players drafted. First carry for Damian Harris, a freshman. Pressure, incomplete. Once again, trying to
what you do as well, but it is to go fast. Good punt.
Another good one from J.K. Scott. Batiste got bowled over, and that'll be kick catch interference and inside.
Kick catch interference, number three, kicking team. Penalties 15 yards from the spot of the foul. First down.
Stock still to throw. Lobs one out. They finally whistle a dead forward.
I think they're going to be they're going to have a great season in Conference USA. They've got a lot of talent.
Batted down at the line. They hit him again. That time on the release. He got. Trying to angle it. Nicely done.
Cam Robinson. Pretty good old lineman in his own right.
There's Calvin Ridley, that freshman you've been raving about. He takes. There's the toss to Stewart. That's a pass from Bateman, and he's able to slip out at the edge.
As I guess it's gone by him.
Not to Stewart. Faked outside, cut inside. Picks up a first down. Here is Damian Harris. And Harris is carrying guys with him to midfield. You talk about the sophomore class that they have right now, there'll be a lot more. That's Ridley again. Nowhere to go for Damian Harris. He stands at the 10. You got a whistle. Well, there's some concern about
the
punting game.
The Lev gang, number 15 offense. 5-yard penalty, still fourth down.
But J.K. Scott said he's been working on his drops. Well, that drop was good. The kick was perfect right at the 10. And maybe they take the field next after finishing off Middle Tennessee today.
Of course, Tennessee, another physical team as well. They can spread you out if they need to.
Alabama has the toughest schedule in the country. And Stock still tries to run it, and because of that,
better when you get into the meat of the schedule there.
Richard Mullaney back to return this one. Back it up to the 33. He's got daylight on the left side if he can get there. Got a key block. A little bit of a stiff arm, and he takes it into middle territory. Freshman from Kentucky at tailback. Play action. Bateman going over the middle. Complete. Big first down to Ty Flournoy Smith. Here's Harris. Harris inside the 10. Bateman rolling. Looking. Intercepted. Picked off at the goal line. Here comes Cottrell. He's got green grass in front of him, but Harris chasing. The freshman running back tracks him down. 80 yards. Officially a 77-yard return. New quarterback Austin Grammer. He's a runner, and he keeps it from American Christian Academy right here in T-Town. Now looking to the end zone. The scramble. Trying to win a foot race and out of bounds at the 15-yard line. They bring Tucker into the backfield. Grammer throws end zone all alone.
Another touchdown.
Extra point fits in the right upright. They gave away. Awfully impressive Thank you, Laura. Return bobbled by Drake. Surrounded by white shirts and the special teams has left.
It's only the second game of the year.
We're thinking still about the Cleveland Browns already. Haynes, his senior year, and still rushed for just under 1,500 yards.
Here's the toss to him. And beautiful cutback. The vision. The speed. And Tamian Harris is at midfield. Defense for Alabama. They fake the toss. Bateman. Oh, he got leveled.
Because guys are going low as you're coming in and you can't redirect your body. But the rules are the rules.
I saw some things where there's room for growth, and not only by Jake Coker, but Connor Bateman as well.
With the throw from Cooper Bateman. Harris straight ahead. First down for Alabama.
Nice. You know, substitute. That's all part of Alabama's, you know, pedigree, so to speak. Is when you can sit.
He was in the thick of things in the quarterback race. It was a five-man race until Nick Saban and Lane Kiffin whittled it to two. Derek Keefe now in a wide receiver. They go straight ahead, and they pick up the first down.
Pass protection, and Coker was in the game.
Ronnie Clark inside the 20. This has been a presentation of the SEC ESPN Network. Now, here's Dari in the studio.